What I'm going to demonstrate here is process of boiling. Students often think of the process of boiling as involving having to heat up something to get it to pretty high temperatures in order to get a substance to boil. As well, they don't always associate the process of boiling with an endothermic type of process or feeling cold. This particular demonstration is referred to as boiling cold, and I do this when discussing properties of liquids. Students need to know what the boiling process is. They've already had that knowledge conveyed to them, and the hope is they remember it. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take some butane, and I'm going to spray that into a Ziploc-type bag and seal the bag, and we'll see what happens. What I'm holding up now is a bag with liquid butane, and notice the bag is filling up. Notice the bubbles. Butane is boiling, and it's boiling at a temperature far below 100 centigrade. And in fact, touching this feels very cold. And I always tell the students, touch with a very sensitive part of your hand, either here or on the bottom of your wrist, because that you can tell differences in temperatures much more easily. This is very cold. This is boiling cold. Well, why does butane boil at such a low temperature? Well, you can start talking about the forces of attraction again. The molecule butane is a nonpolar molecule. Force of attraction are exceedingly weak. Dispersion forces. Notice the butane starting to fill the bag as it boils. And I'll pass this bag around along with another one. But I tell students, if the bag starts to get pretty full, open it up a little bit, or hand it to me. I'll open it up in the fume hood and let the butane go into the fume hood. But let's take a look at a chart on the easel here to see what's happening. Okay. This is a phase diagram similar to that of butane. And we'll notice that when the pressure is atmospheric pressure and the temperature is 0.5 degrees centigrade, our liquid and gas phases are in equilibrium. That's the process known as boiling. In the can of butane, the pressure is above 760, and so butane boils at a temperature much higher than 0.5 degrees centigrade. That's why the butane isn't boiling in that can. But as soon as we reduce the pressure above the butane by letting some of the butane out of that can, we drop down to atmospheric pressure, and we get to a point at which the temperature is 0.5 degrees centigrade, because the butane is at equilibria, both liquid gaseous phase. Now, the last question, why is the butane colder than even 0.5? Drops below that. Well, they might remember that the boiling process is an endothermic process. It takes energy from the surroundings. The air is part of the surroundings. Wait. We're part of the surroundings. You don't want to be part of the system when a reaction's going on. That's not a good thing. Unless, of course, it's the desired effect. But I prefer to remain as part of the surroundings. So, going back to our bag of butane, we see that there's no more liquid. It's all vaporized. It's all boiled away. And there's very little in the way of condensation from the air that water had condensed on the outside of the bag because the bag was so cold. But now as the bag's warming up, it's gotten energy from the surroundings, it's gone back to room temp, I have only liquid, or excuse me, only gaseous butane there and no liquid. And so that then gives students an idea that not everything boils at 100 centigrade, and in fact, very few things boil at 100 centigrade.